ஆழ்வார் எம்பெருமானார் ஜீயர் திருவடிகளே சரணம். ஜீயர் திருவடிகளே சரணம். ஸ்ரீ பகவத்கீதா 16th சாப்டர் தெய்வாசுர சம்பத் விபாக யோகம். தெய்வாசுர விபாக யோகம். பகவான் இஸ் டிஃபரன்ஷியேட்டிங் பிட்வீன் டிவைன் அண்ட் டெமோனியக் பீப்புள் அண்ட் தேர் குவாலிட்டிஸ். தெய்வ மீன்ஸ் டிவைன், ஆசுர மீன்ஸ் டெமோனியக் ஈவில். ஸோ நோபிள் அண்ட் ஈவில் குவாலிட்டி qualities are identified here by Bhagavan. In the first several chapters, Bhagavan already explained about divine qualities, because as part of performing karma yogam, jnana yogam, bhakti yogam, one has to be in divine mindset. One cannot be in an evil mindset and perform those yogam. So Bhagavan has already explained how a divine person will be in previous chapters. So he is spending more time in explaining the demoniac qualities and persons who are having such demoniac qualities. That is what is being discussed in this particular chapter by Bhagavan. For Bhagavad Gita, Bhagavad Ramanuja has given beautiful Sanskrita Vyakhyanam commentary named Gita Bhashyam. Vedanta Acharya has given Tatparya Chandrika, which is another Sanskrita Vyakhyanam. With the help of these two, Puttur Sri V. Krishnaswamy Iyengar has given elaborate Tamil meanings, Tamil commentary for Bhagavad Gita. He has also given word by word meanings for each shlokam. With the help of the word by word meanings, we are going through simple explanation for Bhagavad Gita. Let us now start from 11th shlokam. Chintam aparimeyam cha pralayantam upashritaha kamopa boga parama ஏதாவதிதி நிஷ்சிதாஹ. Let us see the word by word meanings. அபரிமேயம், இம்மெஷரபிள். பிரளயந்தாம் ச, பிரளயந்தாம் ச, டு எக்ஸிஸ்ட் அண்ட் அச்சீவ் அண்டில் தி டெலியூஜ். சிந்தாம், ஒரிஸ். உபாஷ்ரிதாஹ, ஹேவிங். சோ இன் திஸ் பர்டிகுலர் ஸ்லோகம் பகவான் இஸ் எக்ஸ்பிளைனிங் தி குவாலிட்டிஸ் ஆஃப் டெமோனியாக் பீப்புள். From 11th shlokam to 18th shlokam, this is elaborated. What are all the different aspects which are present in demoniac people? That is explained in detail in these shlokams. Here in this particular shlokam, Bhagavan is explaining that these people, demoniac people, though no one is guaranteed to leave even one day, we are not sure whether we will leave tomorrow or not. Still, these people, demoniac people, will desire to achieve so many things even until the deluge. When the pralayam happens, until that time, they think that they will exist and they will have to achieve so many things. They will keep worrying about those. That is explained in this particular first part of the shlokam. And then, kamopa boga paramaha, considering lust as the highest goal, yetavati iti nishchita, firmly believing that this is the highest goal, they will hope for worldly pleasures. The lust is the main objective for them. They remain firmly believing that this is the ultimate goal. They cannot see beyond body, so they are fully focused on bodily enjoyment. So that is explained in 11th shlokam. Now, 12th shlokam. Asha pasha சதைர் பத்தாஹ காமக்ரோத பராயணாஹ ஈஹந்தே காம போகார்த்தம் அன்யாயேனார்த்த சஞ்சயான். ஹியர் பகவான் இஸ் சேயிங் தட் தே வில் கோ ஆஃப்டர் லஸ்ட் அண்ட் ஃபார் தட் லஸ்ட் டு ஃபுல்ஃபில் தேர் லஸ்ட் தே நீட் லாட்ஸ் ஆஃப் வெல்த். Because you can see in this world that those who are wealthy, they are able to fulfill their desires easily. So hence, these people will try to accumulate wealth even through illegal means, even through ignoble means. So that is explained in this particular shlokam, and that is because they are bound by the rope of desire. They have so much desire that they are completely tied down by these desires, and desiring for lust they will even try to get wealth through wrong means. That is explained in this shlokam. Let us see the word by word meaning. Asha pasha shataihi baddaha, being bound by hundreds of ropes known as desires. Each of this desire is like a rope which binds us completely. Kama krodha parayanaha, being well engaged in lust and anger. They have so much lust, they want to attain joy through lust, and anyone who is stopping them from attaining this, fulfilling their lust, they show their anger on such people who are stopping them from achieving this. So they are filled with lust and anger constantly. Kama bogartham, to gratify their lust, anyayena, through wrong means, artha sanjayan, collection of wealth, ihante, yarn for, they long for collecting wealth even through wrong means. In four purusharthams, that is dharma, artha, kama, moksha, moksha is also considered, dharma, artha is also considered as a proper purusharthaṁ, a goal to be attained by a purusha. But that artham, wealth, that should be accumulated through righteous ways. Even when one is doing some work and getting paid for that, as per dharma shastram, as per shastram, one should ensure that even those who give money for their work, that money should be free of any bad karma. So that is essential. So when we earn wealth, when we get wealth, that should be free of any bad karma. But today we see that it is completely impossible, even to some extent, that if we are earning wealth, that means there is some amount of wrong means involved in earning that wealth, by not by us necessarily, but even by those who give us the wealth. So, but Shastram says that when we earn wealth, it should be in the right way, not through wrong means. But those who are having this lust, to gratify their lust, they need wealth. For that, they are even prepared to collect wealth through wrong means. So that is explained in this 12th shlokam about the demoniac people. 13th shlokam. Idam adhya maya labdham imam prapsye manoratham idam astidham api me bhavishyati punardhanam. So this next few shlokams, Bhagavan is highlighting how the individual, demoniac individual, who is having demoniac asura qualities, he thinks, idam, all these, land, children, wealth, all of these, adhya, now, maya, by my ability, labdham, attained. The individual always pridefully thinks, I attained all this wealth, I attained all my children, my land, my wealth, and so on. Everything is attained by me. Imam manoratham, this object which is desired, praksye, will attain with my own ability. He thinks, this man who is prideful, he thinks, I can attain anything, I can attain the object which is desired by me. Idam dhanam asti, I have this wealth due to my ability. All of these wealth, they are accumulated by my own ability, they are not given by anyone. Dhanam, this wealth which I desire to attain, me punaha bhavishyati, I will attain again due to my own ability. Some people say, even if I lost wealth now, I can easily make that again, I can easily acquire wealth again. So such prideful thoughts, such attitude is shown by Bhagavan here as demoniac. Now again we see that most people are running behind wealth these days, but Bhagavan says that this is not the way to do it. When we acquire wealth, it should be done through proper dharmika ways, and it should be spent also for dharma kaikaryams, dharma dharmika activities. So that is 13th shlokam. Now 14th shlokam. Asau maya hatas shatrur hanishye chaparan api ishvaroham aham bhogi siddhoham balavan sukhi. This also highlights the thought process of a demoniac person. This ishvaroham aham bhogi is quoted in many places in Vyakhyanam, in the commentaries by our acharyas. That is nothing but saying that I am the Lord, I am the enjoyer. That attitude is present in many of us. That should be gotten rid of, that should be eliminated. So let us see the word by word meaning. Maya, by me, who is very strong. Asau shatruhu, this my enemy. Hataha, is slain. Aparan, apicha, shatru, and many other enemies. Hanishye, I who am valorous will kill. So this person who is demoniac will think that I have killed my enemy, and I can kill many more of my enemies. I have the ability to do so. Ishwaraha aham. Aham Ishwaraha. I am the controller of everyone. Aham Bogi. I am the enjoyer of everything. Aham Siddhaha. I am all capable. Aham Balavan. I am powerful. Aham Sukhi. I am naturally joyful. So this person, demoniac person, is always thinking like that. I am the controller of everyone. I am Ishwara. Aham Ishwara. Only Bhagavan can say Aham Ishwara, because he is the true Lord of everyone. But everyone else, they are subservient to Bhagavan. They are all servitors of Bhagavan. But everyone claims that I am the controller of everyone. Aham Bhogi, I am the enjoyer of everything. Again, Bhagavan is the true enjoyer, but everyone thinks that we are the enjoyers. Aham Siddhaha, I am all capable. Aham Balavan, I am all powerful. Sukhi, I am naturally joyful. So this thought process go in the minds of demoniac people, says Bhagavan in this particular shlokam. With this we will stop today and we will continue on in the next session. Alvar Emperumanar G.R. Thirumudigale Saranam, G.R. Thirumudigale Saranam.
To learn such valuable information about our Sri Vaishnava Sampradaya, please download Koyil, K-O-Y-I-L app from Google Play Store or Apple App Store. Our website is koyil.org, K-O-Y-I-L.org.